Let's take a look at SOLIDWORKS bottle-based definition. It's just like SOLIDWORKS drawings, only completely different. Drawings have always been a means to an end. I have an idea, I want it made, and I want it made right. So we have this universal language of drawings to help communicate complicated three-dimensional ideas and requirements with our only available medium, 2D paper. But luckily, 2D paper drawings are super easy to understand and can be easily interrogated by any user. And vendors or production can quickly convert our drawings into usable models for their CNC toolpaths with little to no effort. Okay, you get it. Drawings present a lot of unique challenges, but luckily SOLIDWORKS MBD can overcome those with a workflow that's similar to what we do today, just a little different. The first critical difference is we want to start with end consumption in mind. Can we leverage the 3D data somewhere downstream in our process? Can we automate steps in the process of our CNC, FerroArm, or some other tool that interprets 3D dimensional data? To start this workflow, we need to add dimensions and annotations directly to the 3D model geometry with DimExpert. DimExpert dimensions have actually been in SOLIDWORKS since 2008, and to use them, we simply add dimensions directly to model faces like we do with dimensions and drawings. We can even use powerful auto-dimensioning schemes to help us automate the process. There are options for part type, tolerance, and patterning dimensions. And we have the ability to check our model for tolerance status, or even use Tall Analyst. DimExpert is the foundation of SOLIDWORKS MBD. It's a similar method to adding dimensions, just slightly different. Here's the real kicker. It's not really part of the MBD license. Now don't tell anybody I told you this, but you could start using DimExpert to get manufacturing dimensions on your model without spending a dime. As far as toolpaths go, we'd be fine to run with just DimExpert if our tools understand native SOLIDWORKS files with DimExpert dimensions. In fact, SOLIDWORKS CAM can use those dimensions against rules-based machining to automate G-code creation. But let's say I want to interact with some other software that can't interpret DimExpert, or what if I want to send my requirements to an outside vendor that I don't want to have access to my native SOLIDWORKS design intent? Instead of recreating the CAD geometry in another program, SOLIDWORKS MBD steps in and allows us to export out Step 242 files. These are just newer versions of the step format that include product manufacturing information. With a Step 242 file, we can send our vendors a neutral file clear of all of our design intent with all the relevant PMI that their CNC program needs to automate the G-code creation. Or we could send this file to our quality department to generate their FerroArm inspection pass, or even generate a first article inspection reports with SOLIDWORKS inspection. So SOLIDWORKS MBD's first true slight difference is the ability to get PMI data in a neutral file format that a toolpath or inspection software can use and understand via Step 242 file. Now, if all we ever need to do is trust our PMI has been applied appropriately and we have no need to organize this information for any human consumption, we're all set. But let's be honest, looking at a model with a bunch of PMI data is annoyingly complex. So probably the most important feature of SOLIDWORKS MBD is the ability to create 3D views. To create 3D views which are reminiscent of traditional drawing views, we select specific annotation views we want to see and orient the model in our viewport. We can capture multiple unique 3D views to help us easily digest this PMI data. We can even make these views configuration specific, create section views, or even a break view. The beauty of 3D views is we rapidly switch between views with a double click. SOLIDWORKS MBD applies all the pertinent view information, configuration changes, and reorients the model for me. All right, what they don't want me to tell you is that you don't even have to have a SOLIDWORKS MBD license to use these views. The 3D views are stored with the CAD model and available for consumption with any SOLIDWORKS CAD license. So if you don't have SOLIDWORKS MBD, you can see the 3D views and you can switch between them, but you can't change or update the views. The power of 3D views are critical. They're what make all this PMI information understandable by us mere mortals. They make SOLIDWORKS MBD feel less different than traditional drawings we're used to. Now, if all we ever want to do is create consumable content for our SOLIDWORKS community, we're done. But what if we need PDFs for our purchasing team? Or maybe we have approvers who use e-drawings so they don't use up a SOLIDWORKS license. SOLIDWORKS MBD has a 3D PDF template editor to build our own style of drawing, which gives us the ability to export data as a 3D PDF that's consumable by anybody with Adobe Reader. These 3D PDFs are interactive, dynamic, and bring a whole new meaning to the word clarity. Dimensions cross-highlight, users can zoom, rotate, and pan. During the export, we even have the option to automatically create a STEP 242 file that can be embedded right within the 3D PDF, and all the information is together in one file for our vendor. Users can even measure if we forgot a dimension instead of interrupting our day. And for added security, if we don't want users to measure at all, we could also export to eDrawings. With eDrawings, users can still navigate our design with the ease and clarity of 3D PDFs, and it's all for free. With SOLIDWORKS MBD, we export easier to understand, more relevant data for others with 3D PDFs and eDrawings in a similar manner to drawings, just slightly different. All right, SOLIDWORKS MBD isn't exactly like SOLIDWORKS drawings, but it's not completely different either. It's a tool that allows us to use a workflow that focuses on our end goals, where we export out data that others can actually use while simplifying the chaos for us along the way. Everything is all focused around what we care about most, the original model we want made right. Give Computer-Aided Technology a call at the number listed below, and we can walk through how your organization can make that shift today.